Give me your hands. Reach down, grab your baby.
Yes, baby, yes.
42.
Yes.
What are you? Boy or girl?
Girl.
Baby girl. Oh. Baby girl.
What's today? October? Thursday, October 29th, and today is baby day. We are headed
7 a.m.
7:04 a.m. We were supposed to be there at 7, and here we are in traffic. The hospital's like maybe like, well, 15 minutes away, so we'll be alright. But we're going to have baby today. Or tomorrow. Very soon. How you feeling?
Feeling right now? Oh, man, I woke up hella excited, for real. Like, I had a dream about her again, that she was coming, and I feel like I saw, like, more of her this time. So I'm pumped. I'm geeked, but at the same time, I'm nervous as shit. I'm sweating right now. Which is crazy, man, because, like, if it was, like, really, really, like, super, like, my water broke, like, get me out of here, I'd be really freaking the fuck out.
A wreck. You
know? I don't got to do any work in this process.
That's not true. You're gonna
I got my chance. I googled my chance and stuff like that.
My chance.
I'm gonna be like Phil Jackson.
Best coach ever. Yeah, you're my emotional support partner. That's what your official title is.
Oh, okay.
Or birthing partner. So.
ESP?
ESP, yes. I'm just excited to meet this little person. She'll finally be here.
Does she move a lot this morning, or?
I've been off and on since, 6 o'clock, and she was moving around, although I think she just feels like she just moves a little less, and I don't know if that's because she's doesn't have a ton of room or what, but the contractions come and go. I went to the doctor on Tuesday. So 2 days ago, I was 2 centimeters and 50% effaced. She's like, your cervix is favorable. So, yay. I'm not sure. I got a lot of respect for doctors who could just stick their finger up somebody's vagina and measure a really small hole. So hopefully maybe probably late tonight or early tomorrow would be ideal. So we'll keep vlogging and we'll keep you guys posted. This is the resort we're staying at.
Or are you going to be on the top floor?
It looks like Atlantis.
It does look like that from the Bahamas, right? It sure does. Damn, look at those. Look at the big suite all the way up top. Man, which one are we going to be in? The bottom floor?
I don't know where labor and delivery is. Ooh.
So how you feeling?
Very large. Good.
Yeah.
We made it. We bellied the car.
Mm-hmm. We had some issues with the car seat.
we gotta figure this out before. We had to leave the baby in the car because we could get the car seat out.
Okay, we got our seat. Ooh. Very cute.
Stylish in my. Checking in later. I'm so excited. I got my surgeries going just for this moment. Can't wait to see my baby girl.
Ooh. Okay, I'm in triage right now until my COVID test comes back, and then they'll move me to a real room. And this room is not pretty, but they got me hooked up to monitors. I have a lovely little view here. Definitely nothing special. Apparently a couple days ago, happy National Black Cat Day. Back in again when we actually get moved to our real room. Let's pray to God my test is negative. So I don't know.
Here she is.
Okay,
Yeah, you're a little nervous, a little shiny. All right, so how do you feel?
Good. This bed's really hard.
Yeah. Thank you. 8:23 a.m. 9:38. So the countdown started. So yeah, you were telling them about the pill that they put in your mouth.
Yeah, it's just I think it's called Cytotec. And that is kind of, I guess, for when you're earlier on. Because I'm like she said about 3 centimeters and 80% of face. So I've definitely made progress since Tuesday. Which makes me think this baby was coming anyway. You know, maybe not today, but probably over the weekend. Which is good. They were like, that's a great starting point. She was like, if I had to rate your cervix, I'd give it a 10 out of 10.
That's awesome. You got a 10 out of 10 cervix. That's awesome. I don't even know what that means, but that sounds great.
But now we just wait and hang out and watch TV and do stuff, and Aaron eats snacks and I watch. Oh, I guess I just check you periodically and we just kind of wait until contractions start. Mm-hmm. Start to be more powerful and more regular. Because I've been having them just not with any kind of consistency or intensity.
He obviously pulled up to this very beautiful I almost called it a hotel.
You get the lobby area.
Yeah, Huntington here in LA, Pasadena. And I'm like, ooh, you know, maybe we'll get up to the fancy floor. Like, you know, I got PPO insurance, you know. We good. Like, yeah, we'll take the top floor.
We'll take the room with the view.
Yeah, next to Kim and Chloe, you know, like, hook us up.
I wonder
what's
out there.
I'm going to show them. So, yeah, and ultimately what we ended up getting was definitely the ground floor when you walk in. pretty sure I could see, like...
the ocean view.
Yeah, we didn't get the ocean view, but, you know, you totally see people, like, walking around and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's what happens. PPO didn't... you know, take care of me. Here, this is where I'm gonna sleep. You know, this is for all the fellas, you know, like, hey, I'm 6 feet, but you know, we got a nice young twin. Nice young twin rollout sofa. You know, this is definitely like got like you know, Chicago Red Line train vibe seatings. If you're from Chicago, you know what that's about. We got our bet phone right here. That's where we, you know, this is where we call in our food orders off the menu. That's some machinery here. So this is where you get your drip.
So that's good.
Drip, drip. So this is real drip, y'all. That's blinging. Yeah. Does it feel good?
Yeah, she stuck me right here. That shit hurt.
Yeah, it hurt?
It was really painful.
Oh, man.
She was like, oh, you have really tough, thick skin. And I'm like, please don't poke me again. But she ended up poking me in the hand instead.
Yeah, I actually hated that when I had my hand hurt.
It's pretty uncomfortable.
Yeah. All right. And lastly, you got your little apple juice here.
This is like 3 sips.
Oh, I got another one for you.
You don't like apple juice?
No, I was going to drink it, but I was like, you had two, but I felt guilty. So I stole one from you. But
because you didn't order apple juice for
I did not order apple juice. But here you go.
The disrespect.
Sadly, I ate those pancakes too fast and I have to go. But I'm like really really self-conscious about it. Because like if I go and she comes back into the room, Sandra's like locked down here, she's gonna know that I did it. And it's a breakfast pancake syrup poop, so no, that's gonna be
you
stinky.
You should go right now while we have the most time left.
What if I like go out the room and like go on somebody else's
you
room?
Can't leave the room.
She didn't say I couldn't leave the room.
She said we can't leave the room.
Well, you can't. Obviously, Mofo, you like hooked up to
I
the drip machine.
Walking around, you're potentially COVID infected.
Okay, let's see, it's 11:18 now. Still no baby. The baby didn't come in 2 hours like we thought it was gonna go. No. Somebody's tired, because she didn't get that much sleep last night. You can go back to sleep.
feel now?
Huh?
How do you feel now?
Oh, okay. I'm just tired.
That's
one. It's 1:20, and we've made a little bit of progress, which is exciting. My doctor actually came. I hadn't expected seeing her. I hear so many people talk about how they see the doctor when like it's like go time, and that's it. But she came, stopped by, and checked me, and we're like 3 centimeters. 60% of face, baby's really low, so that's a good sign. I just had another dose of Cytotec under my tongue. It's really gritty. It doesn't taste like horrible, but it doesn't taste that good. But it's all good in the neighborhood. Being checked is not fun. And I've been checked 3 times so far, once on Tuesday, twice today. And like this third one, I'm good, bro. Like, but can't
you
avoid.
She pushed it to 4, though.
Can't avoid that, though. So I might be as open as like 4 centimeters. So. I got a little bit of a nap, which was needed, but then the baby kept falling off the monitor. Aaron's over here watching the monitor go crazy and don't want to call nobody.
Yeah, like it went off, like the sound went off, and I was like, is that right?
He's like, yeah, it was like 60, and then it was like 7, and then it was like 220, and da-da-da. I'm like,
I shut off for a little bit too. I was like,
I'm like, you weren't gonna say nothing.
I like put my finger underneath your nose to see if you breathe.
We'll check in a little bit. Not much going on right now, but I'm surprised I'm so dilated, and I don't. She was like, are you in any pain? I'm like, no. He's like, oh, you got the epidural. I'm like, no.
How are you feeling?
I'm just a little emotional right now. I was telling Aaron how I was just like, even though we're being induced, it's not, the reason is not because I'm anxious to not be pregnant anymore. I've actually had a really, aside from a little hiccup with my like back and stuff, like I've had a wonderful experience and really kind of sad that it's coming to an end. And, you know, like I think any pregnant person will tell you like, having your baby inside of you and like feeling them move around and being able to protect them is like something so special. But I'm also just like, you know, excited for her to be here so we can like, you know, start our lives together as a family. Cause you know, dads play the sideline, play the bench, ride the bench for the majority of the pregnancy. And especially with COVID, like he hasn't been able to be involved in like go to appointments and like hear a lot of the conversations firsthand. And you know, I'm just like really excited because like he's been so excited, you know, and like a lot of dads and especially like where I come from, people are just like really nonchalant about it. Like, oh, and you know, I didn't have a dad growing up and she's gonna have everything that I didn't have in best possible way. And I'm really, he was like nesting yesterday and it was just, he was so excited. He's like, I gotta get all this stuff done. I gotta get my dad corner ready and make sure my t-shirt's ironed and kind of make the best first impression. like, she's not gonna be able to see you, but yes, I like where you're going with this. So it's just a really amazing experience to have such a, you know, committed partner. And he's been amazing my entire pregnancy.
Aww.
Yeah, you're gonna be the best daddy.
Aww.
And I love you. I won't do this with anybody else.
I love you too, babe.
So, yeah. Oh, I'm like, it's not me, it's the drugs. So I'm room 4, SH, the purple line are my contractions. And they are little baby, like look at this person in room 8, like it was off the chart. Oh, look at this little vibe right here. Little baby contractions.
Yeah. Yeah. What was the like pain level? shit, they're getting up there, huh?
Yeah. I think here comes another one.
Dang, so it tells you like before?
Well, when you see the line start to go up. Mm-hmm. When you see the line start to go up.
Where are you at again?
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm.
You feel one? No, but it's like it leaves like a almost like a radiation kind of like in your like in my lower back.
All right, let's breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left, right, breathe in. Breathe out. Left, right, breathe in. Breathe out. I said, I love myself.
Put me in the game, coach.
Put me in the game, coach. Say, I love myself.
I love myself.
Say, I can do it.
I can do it.
So I can do anything.
I can do anything.
Nope. I can do anything.
I can do anything.
Yes. Out. Yeah. Yeah. Out. Give me a real big.
Yes. I clearly need to pull my own stuff up there.
All right, so.
Update.
Yeah.
They put me back in bed because baby's heart rate, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't where they wanted it to be. And then now they're going to break my water so that they can do internal monitoring and that we can get back on track with induction meds and just make sure that she's, you know, super safe and her heart rate is...
You have one here for instruction. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Got this.
What is her
heart rate saying now? It's 150. Yeah. Okay, chapstick
alert. Had to take a brief intermission.
Yes.
Well, we're not where we wanted to be, but that's okay. My contractions kind of stalled out, and with the Pitocin, baby doesn't like Pitocin. And her heart rate was doing a couple funky things. It never got like to the point where they're worried. Like, oh my God, we need to do something now. But they changed, they made me change positions a couple of times and then they turned off the medicine. So, yeah, the doctor ended up coming in the middle of the night, which I really appreciated. She ended up staying just to kind of monitor me, and once they turned it off and things kind of calmed down, her heart rate was beautiful. And so we're gonna try just a sprinkle of Pitocin, and if that doesn't get my contractions more regular and closer together, then we have to do something else. Mm-hmm. And like, definitely not the route I want to go, but whatever route leads me to a healthy baby and a healthy delivery is what you gotta do, right?
Sure.
So, I've slobbed all over this oxygen mask. This is like not the most comfortable thing, but we got a few hours of sleep.
Yeah.
Aaron, I felt so bad for Aaron on that little couch.
Yeah, it was tough. I think just kind of due to all the stress, I was bundled up in this corner.
But, you know, it's great to wake up and know that mommy is in, you know, high spirits and,
yeah,
you know, that that's a blessing, and that's great.
Yep. So we're just gonna have faith in our doctor and our team and just do what we need to do.
Mm-hmm. You got your epidural machine?
I got this like 8:30 last night.
Yep.
Yeah, I never pushed the button. I forgot there was a button, mm-hmm. but now the contractions are starting up real stuff. So. Ooh, hello. Did I feel anything?
I heard it's like not real.
That was like a placebo. Mm-hmm. Setting up and like we start pushing in 20 minutes, but they're getting the room. They got the warmer on, a bunch of stuff, and Dad is nesting right now.
Yes,
he's nesting. He made sure to clear up his space because she doesn't want him to think he's a junkie guy.
Yes, I brushed my teeth over again. Now I'm gonna put some deodorant on.
Yeah. It's so crazy because I got a little before 11. I was just feeling so like emotional. And I was just like, started talking to her and crying and telling her all the things that we can't wait for. And then it was weird. We had this like crazy huge contraction. And it like spiked off the charts, and like her heart rate was sky high, which is good. And I don't know. I'm just so happy. So we gotta get over this last little hump, huh?
We let her listen to her favorite song.
She listened to Chris Brown forever.
That's the song that her and I kind of have our bonding time in the womb. Like we listen to that at night when mommy's sleeping, and it's like our time together, you know. So.
Yeah.
Maybe that helped, you know. So.
I'm gonna say it helped because I was looking at pictures of newborn babies and all types of stuff. Like, come on, uterus, you got this. But.
Whew. So how was it when she felt down there? What were you thinking?
Well, she could tell that I've been upset, like. Not and like the last time she came in, I was like crying, but it wasn't bad. It was just like thinking through, you know, what life is gonna be like, and I can't wait to, you know, kiss her cute little cheeks and take her home and wrap her up like a little burrito and, you know, all the other things that you can't wait to do with your child. And so I was like, you know, crying, like just feeling the emotions. And she's like, oh, are you okay? And she comes back a little bit later. She's like, oh, since you're feeling pressure, I'm going to go ahead and check you. And then she was sitting at the bed, at the end of the bed, and she leans over and she's like, are you ready to have a birthday party? She's like, are you ready to have a birthday party? And I just like broke down. I'm like, yes, birthday party, please. In this room. I think Aaron was freaked out. I think he was bracing himself for the whole, like, you haven't progressed any, but I feel that one. Oh.
Do you have any messages for her, for Ayla?
I have all the messages and I can't think of any of them right now. But I just can't wait to meet you. It's one of the best days of our lives. We just gotta get through this delivery safely. At about 15 minutes and it's go time. You ready?
Yes. Born ready. I got my t-shirt on. I'm ready.
Oh man. My eyes are all puffy. Okay. We're gonna go now. Mm-hmm. Hopefully this is the exciting part.
There you go.
Good job.
Good job. Okay. Come on. Come on. Okay, give me your hands. Reach down, grab your baby.
Yes, baby, yes.
42.
Yes.
What are you? Boy or girl?
Girl.
Baby girl. Oh.
Girl.
Oh.
Yes, baby, good job.
Happy birthday, Mama. Such a kitty pie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Welcome to the world. You're gonna change the world.
Yeah, you are.
Oh, somebody else has just arrived. You hear that, baby? Some scares and now you're here.
You did good though, Mama. We're proud of you.
Mommy pushed you on out of there. She got it done.
Yeah. She tried. She was like, okay.
Mm-hmm. Jordan in the fourth quarter. So.
Day one. She gave us a run for our money last night. We were up from like maybe 11 to 2, like just trying to figure it out. She was kind of spitting up a little. The nurse today said she might have swallowed a lot of amniotic fluid yesterday and it kind of like made her tummy upset. And so, but we did all kinds of stuff. We like listened to music and, you know, burped her and swaddled her. And she really likes her little starfish swaddle. So
yeah, we learned that she likes to be like swaddled with her hands
with
up.
With her hands up, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's all good. I'm feeling
I mean, I don't feel like on empty, but I'm tired. So we're gonna just hang out. We got a lot of stuff to do today. We got what, birth certificate, and she's got checkups, and we're gonna work on breastfeeding today. She's still figuring out the whole latch thing, which the nurse made me feel better. Like, don't worry that she's, you know, not as interested at this point, because the first 24 hours are really just baby trying to adjust to being out in the world, not necessarily like, you know, grabbing for your boob. So we're gonna work on that, and we had talked about going home today, but maybe we'll stay another night and just make sure that we got a hold of all this. Make sure she's good. But jaundice levels were good as of last night, and yeah. She's such a cute little potato. Starfish.
Yeah. Let's give him a, should we give him a look?
Yeah.
Okay. Hello. Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. Oh.
She likes her little hat.
Mm-hmm. It keeps coming off, though. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See, I like skin to skin, mommy.
Ooh.
Bless you.
Bless you. I think I found my little pet name for her.
Yeah, what?
Squeak.
Squeak.
She makes these like
noises. Yeah, it was like, what was that, 6 a.m? It was like, what are you doing over there?
You might squeak, huh? Yeah. So I think so far we're doing good. We got like from like 3 to 6, we got solid 3 hours, which I think at this point is pretty impressive, right?
Mm-hmm.
How are you feeling? I know you're over there on that.
Yep. So as you can see, I had struggling over there on that couch, but it's cool, you know. Hey, just a day in life. It's never about the dad, so I had to ask like, can I have a pillow? You know.
They were like, no.
Right, sleep on the floor, girl. But
our nurse today was pretty nice about it though. She got him a couple extra pillows and stuff.
Yeah. Well, so. Extra pillows, i.e. that's one pillow over there, just saying, but yeah.
Sorry.
It's cool. It was great. I got a, you know, chance to hold her, you know, some, and
he was on dad duty all night.
Yeah, I took dad duties at night. I felt like every little, you know, shake, you know, was up. We listened to music, so it was pretty cool that, like, we had this idea, like, all right, if we have her listening to music, like a certain playlist, maybe when she's born, she'll like respond to that playlist. And I felt she somewhat did. Like, we had some Stevie playing, and she seemed to really enjoy that. I know it put mom to sleep. So,
no, mom was like,
yeah, so it was good. I think we're going to kind of keep that up. But just from a dad standpoint, like, we brought snacks, like Doritos, and that's gone. They're gone.
No, they're not. There's so, some over there still.
Yeah, I'm hungry. I don't want this food anymore. Like, you know what? The breakfast is good. The lunch is...
The lunch and the dinner are not.
Yeah, I got the spaghetti. It was...
That's nasty. Spaghetti was a bad idea.
Just, like, imagine if Lunchables made, like, if that made, like, spaghetti, that's what it would taste like. That's
a pretty good description.
Yeah.
So, but...
Well, that's it. So
I'm proud of us, though.
Yeah.
She had some reflux this morning, like with that amniotic fluid coming out. We were like, but we figured it out.
Pokey pokey. Pokey pokey. Pokey pokey. Yep. So, all right. Well, that's it. I guess we'll tune in later and let you guys know.
Yep. We'll give you an update later.
Bye.
See you later. It's much later in the day. I feel like it's been a very eventful day, even though we've not done anything. Well, Ava had a bunch of stuff done. She had her 24-hour exam, a hearing test. We had a lactation consultation. and we're actually gonna stay another night just to make sure we have everything down, especially as it relates to like feeding, because she just hasn't been hungry, and we've been working on practicing breastfeeding. So
you smell like Andy ointment.
You smell like, don't talk about my so far our nurse today was really, she's been really cool. She gave Ava a bath.
Oh, honey bunny. I'm a honey bunny. I'm a crybaby. I'm a crybaby.
Did I cry like this?
Yeah. You're like, I don't like that, Dad. Don't do that. You get yourself all worked up. You're all red. You look like a jelly bean. You want your hand free?
I don't even remember last time we checked in. Where were we? I know we were in postpartum, the maternity ward, but we have Miss Cranky Pants Ava here. We just did a diaper change, and we're getting ready to put her going home outfit on because we are checking out. How do you feel?
Tired.
He's over there like nodding off. We have to do one more check-in with the nurse and sign some paperwork and get our bands cut off, and we're out of here. I got my mama. Well, it said. I'm sorry. How dare I prioritize them over you? It's Sunday afternoon. We're gonna head home. It's finally time to get on with our lives. We're done with the hospital stay. And she's doing really well. She passed all of her tests. Hearing's good. Heart. Since they tested something with the heart, that was good. She's been eating regularly. Enough. Wet and poopy diapers. What else? I don't know. Can't think of anything else, but overall, she's doing really well. Pediatrician says she looks great, and we'll obviously have another pediatrician appointment probably like Monday or Tuesday. Probably Tuesday. Because I have to call them tomorrow to let them know that we had the nugget and we need an appointment. So overall, feeling pretty good. I think this new parent thing is very overwhelming. Last night was rough. She did not want to sleep on her own last night. She did not like the hospital's acrylic bassinet. So we ended up just kind of taking turns holding her, trying to keep her calm, trying different things. I always hear day two, like the second night, is really rough because that's when they like, you know, come alive. And they get over that kind of like newborn grogginess, so you really gotta pay a lot of attention and just have a lot of patience and stuff like that. And so I've learned more in the last 4 days than I've maybe learned in an entire lifetime, but it's been the most beautiful experience, and I get to take home the best prize ever. You excited about the prize we get to take home for all our hard work? Dad's like, we gotta get on the road soon. So, well, I'm sure, and I hope you, Ava, watch this video to see how you were brought into the world. And mommy loves you so much.
Daddy loves you.
And daddy loves you so much. And I'm gonna go before I get emotional. We're just happy she's here.
If I had such a thing.
Oh, I can't take it.
I know. I'm looking, she's so cute, her little.
All right. so cute. Hi, Pumpkin. She looks chill. She's not screaming like I thought she would
be. Yeah, she looks really comfortable.
You ready to go home? You ready to go home? Let's go home. Let's blow this pop stand. How about that?
Okay.
You ready to go home?
Yes, very ready to go home. You know, we're leaving. It's beautiful,
at,
mommy.
Look at, we made that.
Yep. Look how comfortable she looks in her little beautiful chair. Special shout out to Nuna. It's beautiful seat. Hi, baby. She looks so comfortable in there.
Oh, I can't believe we did that.
Oh, man. If I had some ovaries, they'd be on fire right now. Oh. And then beautiful sunny California with the mountains in the background. It feels so weird because we've been here for a few days, but can't wait to get home.
Yeah. Cause that is what my heart says. That's what my heart says. I wanna be with you always. Always, yeah. You are my world.